Welcome back. So today we're moving to JavaScript. So, but I want to give you a small assignment to do. So if you look at this page, this is our personal profile website that we just finished. I want you to make a little bit more beautiful. Try to see if you can format this and make sure they are in different sections and see if you can place your picture here. Like your picture is just showing here, put the width, breadth of the picture and put it and put and add your picture here. Like I've already taught you how to add images. So don't forget we have education. So make sure your picture is here. Work. So I've not created the work experience page. So you can as well create it. Then I think I created the others and a place where you can download your CV. So this I've actually also done. So if you have any issues, like I told you can reach out to me on Twitter at Tosin Lubenga. That is my active most active channel. So I'll be creating a community on Discord too soon for software developers so that we can share experiences with people and we can grow a big software development community. So, but as soon as that is available, I'm going to be sharing on this channel. So, we are moving to JavaScript. I'm going to create a new folder and I'm going to create the folder inside HTML. So, I'm going to call it, no, I think that's a file. This is a folder. So, I'm going to call it, JavaScript. Let me just call it JavaScript. Though I would not want to name it that JavaScript, but let me just call it JavaScript. So it means that inside this folder, that is where we have the JavaScript code we are going to be taking. So let's create a new file inside that JavaScript and call that file index.html and click enter. So this is the index.html. So I'm bringing the HTML everything up. You know how we do that. So it automatically comes up when you press HT. So I choose HTML5. So it brings everything for me. So what is JavaScript? As at the time of preparing this course, JavaScript is the most popular web programming language in the world. Is the most popular and the most demanding. To make it well as a web developer, as the case may be, JavaScript is one of those things you need to learn. JavaScript is used for both front end and back end programming. So like web developers, you can be back end, you can be front end. Back end developers are those who write server side codes. The code sits on the server. The front-end developers are those who write code for the client. That means that is the code that your web browser can interpret. Like this is this code now here is a server-side code. If you view page source, so these are just server-side code. So as a JavaScript developer, you can either be a front-end developer focusing on that, or a back-end developer, or you are full stack. Full stack means you are both together. So, like I said, JavaScript is the most popular programming language that you can actually see out there. So, and that's introduce us to the beginning. What we've been doing with HTML, CSS is just web scripting. You understand? They are all web scripting. We've not started programming. It is now we want to write programs. And JavaScript help us to make our web pages to be more interactive. You can interact with it. So let me change the title to JavaScript 101. So now, to write our JavaScript code, you can place the JavaScript in three different pages within your code. You can place it on the header section, that means inside here. Then you can place it immediately before the body section. Then you can make it external, like you make it an external JavaScript code. So we're going to be doing the three of them now with this particular example. So this is going to be your first time of writing a JavaScript code. So let's have an heading. Let's give this a heading. Starting JavaScript. So then the next thing we want to do is we want to have a paragraph P, and give that paragraph an ID. That's ID means identity. So I don't know whether I will make mention of this when I was doing when we were on CSS. That's cascading style sheet. So I'm like, I must have also mentioned that many things, even if they've not been mentioned before, you continue to learn it as we proceed. So this ID is given this paragraph a unique identity. ID means identity. So we are giving that identity, we are just giving it a name. The name is up to you. So I want to name it start. But that's just the identity. So it means we can have another paragraph P that we can call, we can give an identity of end. So this identity is to help me to relate with any of the paragraphs I want to interact with per time. So like I said, JavaScript helps your web pages to be interactive. You understand? You can with a click of a button, you can change things, and that is what is available. So inside here, I'm going to be writing, inside this start, I'm going to be writing, we are waiting. So let's say, for instance, we are waiting to start. Then I'm going to put a button under it so that when I click that button, I want JavaScript to help me change the content of this we are starting. You understand? And also, even we can even put a value inside this end. So, you know, we could start it. So we're going to be doing button, and we're going to just say button. Then this button, we're going to give it a type. Don't forget, this is an attribute. This is an attribute of button. This ID is also an attribute of paragraph, but it's just the name of the attribute is ID, the value is start. So, but it is an identity that helps us to identify that particular paragraph. So button type. So we're going to say type of button. It's just a button. Then we're going to use this attribute called onClick. Okay, so we have onClick, on text menu. There are so many, on drag center. So these are events that can happen on resize, on reset, on show. So there are so many of them that you would use per time when you need them. So for now, we are going to just do onClick. OnClick simply means when you click this button, what should happen? So when we click this button, we're going to be calling a function. A function is a block of code that executes an action. You understand? So JavaScript to write functions, when you're writing PHP, PHP is also a programming language, but basically a server-side programming language backend. You have functions. I will also teach you more about functions as we proceed, but just take it one step at a time. Don't rush this section. It is totally different from everything we've been doing. That is HTML and CSS. It is pure programming that, you know, has to do with a lot of logic. So we're going to be calling that function, but before we call the function, let us first of all write the function. So first of all, I want to put the script on top of on the header section. I will also the browser, when it's reading this script, but the moment it gets to script, it already knows that's a JavaScript code. That's why it is called script. So it's a scripting, it's a programming language. It's a scripting programming language. Then it's also a backend, a server-side programming language itself. So for now, but in this course, I'm just focusing on the front end alone. And also, you will not learn everything about JavaScript in this course, but it's going to give you the background of where you can even build on, go to YouTube and do stuff. I'm going to give you assignment, give you YouTube links of things you can use JavaScript to do, like JavaScript calculator. You know, you follow those instructors and build a JavaScript calculator that, you know, people can interact with. So I'm going to give you that assignment. So script. So we want to put the script here. So we're going to name the function change function. When you are creating a function in JavaScript, first of all type function, you know, change function. So then, so inside this function, when I call this function, I want this code inside to run. So I'm going to say document. I'm saying go inside this document, get an element by ID. There is get element by class name. There is get element by ID. So you can also use class. You can use name. You can even use get element by tag name. All right. So there are so many, you know, get element functions that you can use. So, but we are using get element by ID. So we are saying what is the inside this get element by ID. We are going to be putting the name of the ID in between. All right. So we are going saying get element by ID start. Start. All right. Get element by ID start dot inner HTML. So what this line of code does is that it changes the value. This is the inner HTML. It changes this to a new value that we are going to pass here. Dot inner HTML equals to we have started. So what I want to happen is that the moment you click on this button, it will change the content of this paragraph from we are waiting to we are starting. And how can we do that? Is by select, by using the ID to identify the particular element. All right. So that is just that. So now what we need to do is that this function, change function, we have to put it here, and so that we'll be able to make that happen. So I'm going to say change. So it's even suggesting it for me because it's the ID is intelligent to know that I've created a function called change function. So it's asking, is that the function I want to call? So I will click yes. Then I will not just put the function like that. As you can see, the function, it has open and close parent open and close bracket, which take dummy data or arguments. It takes argument. We'll get to that when we get to JavaScript function. So but don't just worry about that. So you just have to put the arguments inside like this. All right, so automatically the code knows that the moment it clicks on this button, it's going to change it to we have started. So let me save. I think it is saved now. Let me go and open the file so that we can test what we're doing. So don't forget my web folder is there. So I'm clicking, then HTML, then JavaScript. So wherever it is in your own file. So this is the index.html that we've created. All right, so I'm going to open it up. All right. Oh, so this is the button. If I click it now, it's going to change to we have started if I click it now. But I think I made a mistake. I was supposed to put I was supposed to write something on that button. So let me go back to the code here. In between the button, I was supposed to put start. All right, so let me go back here. Yes, so start, so that I can be able to start. So if I click on it now, see, it changed it. We have started. If I click back, nothing is changing. You know, I could loop it so that the moment I keep clicking it, it will keep changing the value inside. We'll get back to that later. So let me refresh again. Let me click start. See, it has changed it to we have started almost immediately. So I can inspect the inspect. So you see what I just did to inspect the element. Let me close it again. Like this is Chrome, all right? So inspect, I'm creating inspect. You know, the other time I clicked view page for us to see page source. But as a JavaScript developer, you are going to be using this inspect a lot to check your code. So part time, we'll be looking at everything we needed. So this is, as I put my mouse on this section, it's telling me that is the old HTML. So look at the header section. We can see even all our code here. So can you see JavaScript? So this is the script that we wrote. All right, this is the body. So this is element. We are looking at this element. and document get element by ID. So it's getting the ID start. So, and this is the button. So it has changed now to we have started. So let me click, as I click start, you will see it's going to also change here. So let me refresh the page. Let me open the body. Okay, we are starting. So let me click start. Automatically, as you can see from the element here, it has even changed to we have started from we are starting. And it's automatically removed the initial word that was there. So let me refresh again so that we can understand what I'm saying. This is the body. So the moment I click start, so just focus on this section, we are starting. So then when I click start, you see it has changed to we have started and automatically eradicates. So what I've actually written as my code can actually change here with the power of JavaScript. So like I said, JavaScript helps make your web pages to be interactive. You can click something, it will be speaking, it will like it's communicating. You understand? So then we'll be using console. If there is an error, in our JavaScript code, this is where we can easily track the error. So source, you will see source as we proceed. You will start understanding how to use source, how to use network, especially when you start communicating with APIs. But for now, just focus on the element and the console. Now the console is throwing an error. The value p for key width is invalid and has been ignored. So I can click. Okay. All right. So that's just ignore that. So it's taking me to the source of that error. So this is where you see the source of everything, your file HTML. So this is the source. So you see the source code here. The same way with, you know, trying to do view source code, view page source, is the same thing that is available here. And it's even giving us the different files inside the folder. So that is the power of JavaScript. So I want to suggest you try and create a button that when you click it to indicate here that we have ended. All right, so try and pause this video and do it, because I'm going to also be doing it now. So just pause. I hope you've done it. So let's get to it. So here I'm going to inside this our script, I'm going to create another function. So I will just, this function already closes by the closing of this parenthesis. So I'm going to come here and say function again. This is going to be our another function. End. I'm going to call it end function. The name can be anything. So I'm going to come here and write document dot get element by ID. This time around, the ID I'm getting is end. That's the paragraph end, and I'm going to do inner HTML equals to. So I want to change the value to we have ended the class. Okay, maybe. So it must be in between two quotes like that. So it will look for the ID and end it. So we need a button that can help us call this function. This is the button that called this function. So we're going to be doing the same thing. And we're going to be writing button. Let me just put on click equals to end function. This. All right. So when I click it, it's going to call the end function. So let me put end here. Then the word, you will observe that initially when we came here, okay, that time that paragraph, this particular paragraph, look at it here, body, this paragraph end, you did not see anything there because we did not put anything there. Nothing is actually inside. the paragraph. So that's why that section is empty. I think I should be able to even edit it. Edit HTML here. Okay, so I can even edit it. So if I write this end, I think it should come up. It's not going to come up. So just let's focus on the what we're actually doing. So this end button, the paragraph with end does not have anything. So but if I click end now, it will come up automatically because it is then that I now have added the HTML element inside. So if I click end, can you see it automatically came up? We have ended the class. If I click start, we are starting. End ends the class. All right, so if I refresh again, let's look at it. Start, we have started. End, we have ended the class. So that's the beauty of JavaScript. It helps you to interact, you know, dynamically with your web page. So let's go back to, so we are talking about the placement of JavaScript code. So let's, so we can as well remove it, we can as well remove it here and put it at the bottom of the element. So I can copy, I can remove it here. That's the second place and put this. All right, it is still the same thing, it will still work. So let's go back, let's refresh. All right, so start is working, end it is working. So you can either put it at the header section or you put it at the just before the closing tag for the body element. So it is going to work. So the last method is that we can actually put the script outside outrightly. Like we can remove it from here and create a new file inside JavaScript. Don't forget, we are doing this inside JavaScript. And we're going to call it main.js. So automatically, you see, it sees that it is a JS code. So, and I will place it inside. I don't need to put script again like this. I don't need to put this script because the whole file is already a script. I've removed it. So because the JS file is already a script. So inside this index.html now, I'm going to include that script source. You understand script? So I'm saying what is the source of the script is inside the same directory with index.html. So I'm going to just put main.js. So it's even suggesting it. So this is the third method of adding your JavaScript code, and that's actually the best method, so that you put it in a different element. So it also means that if we add additional index.html page, obviously we are going to be we can easily put this script at the top of every of the HTML pages, so that it can use the same script. That is one of the advantages of putting it externally, so that if I'm changing one thing, I'm just going to change it in one place. I will not need to change this on all the pages. So let's see if that's going to work. So I'm going to click refresh now. So here, if you look at it on the header section, the script is already there to main.js. And if you even look at the source, is the main.js is already reflecting as one of the codes. So if I click start, we have started. If you click end, we have ended. We have ended the class. All right. So these are the things we can do. So another thing to even make this code a bit reasonable is we can actually do we can actually change go back to the main.js instead of using putting the, you know, the ID for end, I can put the start ID or that's for the paragraph, so that it is just here that everything will be changing. So this one will be off now. I hope you saw what I did inside the mail. I've changed the ID to start, so we are no more referencing this particular paragraph. We are referencing this paragraph, but we have two buttons that can help us to change the content. So if I refresh now, refresh, So if I click start, we have started. If I click end, we have ended the class. You understand? So it's just the same. And if I click start again, it will change it to we have started. If I click end, it changes to we have ended the class. So it makes our code to be dynamic. So that will bring us to the end of this introductory video to JavaScript. So what we're going to be doing now is more of programming. We'll be looking like data types and etc. etc. So follow me on Twitter at Tosin Lugbenga, as you can see on the screen. Ask questions. If you have issues with this page, I can be able to help you to attend to it on the TL. Thank you so much.